Welcome to Hillbank Evangelical Church devotional, and I would like to read from Psalm 103, and I just want to read the first five verses. You notice in this psalm that David doesn't ask for anything. All he wants to do is praise God. Praise the Lord, O my soul, all my inmost being, praise his holy name. Praise the Lord, my soul, and forget not all his benefits. He forgives all your sins and heals your diseases. He redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion. He satisfies your desires with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. You know, now and again, we need a good dose of Psalm 103. Here are five blessings in the first five verses that we must not forget. The first one is, who forgives all your sins? David begins by reminding us that God forgives all our sins. It is not a surprise that he starts here, because this is the foundation for everything else. Our greatest problem is the guilt we feel because of our sin. And our greatest need is to know God's forgiveness. Do you remember the day when Jesus freed you? Do you remember the place when Jesus met you and said, I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have blotted out your sins and they shall be no more. It is a great day when Jesus takes away the pain of sin. When Jesus pardoned my sin, I was so happy, I could hardly take it in. It was probably due to the simplistic way it was done. I just had to say I trust in God, and I believe that Jesus went to the cross and died for me, and his blood cleanses me from all my sin. I knew the moment my sins were forgiven, and I stood on redemption ground. The whole family rejoiced. I still had a whole lot to learn about my Saviour. I still let him down too often, but I know he is my Lord and he is my Saviour. What a God we serve. He is eager to forgive. He's ready to forgive. And he wants to forgive. It's a wonder we've been forgiven at all. Fully, freely, and forever. The second one is he heals all your diseases. 1 Peter 2:24 says, he himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that we might die to sins and live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. And so spiritually we are daily under the Father's care, and he visits us just as a doctor visits us, the patient. God is healing our spiritual diseases as they arise day by day. No spiritual disease baffles his skill. He goes on healing all until the last trace has gone from our nature. We should enjoy pondering upon these blessings we receive from the Lord, who daily forgives and heals us spiritually. We should have no doubt about it. We are ransomed, healed, restored, and forgiven. The third one is, who redeems your life from the pit? I'll never forget hearing the Brooklyn Tabernacle Choir in concert. The sincerity and depth of feeling the singers brought to the music showed that it was more than a mere performance. And when they sang, I'm not afraid anymore. Fear of violence, fear of not having enough money, fear of what might happen to their children, fear of not being able to get the drugs they needed to feed their addiction, and fearing every day. As the soloist Calvin Hunt sang, the spotlights on the platform and on him showed tears flowing down his cheeks. No wonder Calvin spent years and years as a crack cocaine addict on the streets of Brooklyn before being transformed and being saved through the blood of Jesus and forgiven of his sins. The fourth one is, he crowns you with love and compassion. The older translations say that he crowns us with loving kindness. It's the loyal, unending, unchanging love of God towards us. He heaps up his blessings and then he pours them on us. And then he crowns us with tender mercies. Why doesn't he say tender justice? Well, there's nothing tender about justice. If we were to receive what we truly deserve from God, we would stand no chance. But instead of justice, God gives us tender mercy. And what is the crown? It is a crown of life. The crown of the Christian is a new kind of living, which is life indeed. Through Jesus Christ, we have entered into life more abundant. And the fifth one is, who satisfies your desires with good things. That means there's nothing on the earth that can satisfy us more deeply except God himself. The good of verse 5 comes from God, not from anything we see around us, not from certain material benefits, money or status or promotion or some sort of earthly prosperity. The things of this world are only temporary, and our desires can only come from eternal things. But the emphasis is not on what we possess, but on what possesses us, what's in our hearts. Here David speaks of satisfaction deeper than anything the world can offer. So what about us? How are our desires satisfied? Well, we need to go back to verse 2. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. What are our benefits? They are a sustaining joy and an inward peace. He forgives, he heals, he redeems, crowns, and he satisfies. We should cultivate our relationship with Christ so that we can enjoy these benefits now and for eternity. May God bless you. Amen.